Hello students, welcome to the new lecture. And in this lecture we are going to discuss about the two topics. Okay, the two topics, they are studying enzyme chart. Okay, next is the flow chart of human digestive system. These are the two topics that we are going to discuss in this lecture. Okay, the first topic is the studying enzyme chart. Okay, what is an enzyme? Okay, we know that what the chart is. Okay, what is an enzyme? Enzyme is nothing but a substance, okay, a substance that acts on some products to further digestion or some other biological process, okay, that is an enzyme. Okay, so here the enzymes are substance, okay, enzyme or substance, both are same. There are different type of enzymes and secreted by different glands and secreted into different regions, and digestive juice act on and product. Okay, first see the enzyme. What is the function of enzyme? Let us see. We will take the amylase. Okay, amylase, salivary amylase or normal amylase. So this is the starch. Okay, this is the starch. What is starch? Starch is nothing but is a complex carbohydrate that present in the plants. So if you eat the starch material, what will happen in your body? There is an enzyme known as amylase. Okay, the amylase is present. This amylase is going to convert the starch into glucose molecules. Okay, it means what the amylase is doing. Amylase is going to act on the starch and helps in the digestion of the starch. Hence, after that breakdown of the starch, you will see the formation of glucose molecules. Okay, it is an enzyme. It is nothing but it's a digestion process. Digestion of starch. Okay, this is the function of the amylase enzyme. Okay, in the same way, other enzymes also do. What are those other enzymes? The pepsin. Okay, pepsin, it is an enzyme. Okay, amylase is also an enzyme. Trypsin is an enzyme. Lipase, peptidase, and so on. There are many enzymes. So the enzymes are substrate here in the first left column is present. Next is secreted by. What is secretion? Secretion and excretion. These are the two different terms. Secretion is nothing but there is a gland. The glands are going to produce some kind of substance. Okay, that substance is released. Okay, that substance is released in some other organ. Okay, gland means it is organ like structure. It is going to produce and release in somewhere, that is known as secretion. Okay, this such kind of release is known as secretion. Okay, so excretion means it is produced in the body and released outside the body. So the secreted by, which gland is going to secrete the enzyme? Okay, if you take the ptyalin or salivary amylase, it is secreted by the salivary glands. Salivary glands are going to secrete the ptyalin. So next, these salivary glands, where they are secreting its compounds? These salivary glands are releasing ptyalin in the buccal cavity. Buccal cavity means what? The mouth region. That is known as buccal cavity. So if the salivary amylase is released into the buccal cavity by salivary glands, what they do? They are going to act on the saliva. They are present in the saliva. It means in the saliva there is a digestive juice that is known as ptyalin, and this enzyme is going to act on the carbohydrate. So what is carbohydrate? The starch is a complex carbohydrate, and so on. Whatever the carbohydrate is, complex carbohydrate is there, so it is going to act on it. Okay, next, if the carbohydrate is acted by the salivary amylase, what will happen? The carbohydrate is broken down into simple sugars, that is known as maltose. Okay, maltose or some other products. So next is the pepsin. Pepsin is, it is an enzyme. Okay, This enzyme is secreted by the gastric glands. What is known by gastric glands? A glands which is present in the alimentary canal, that is known as gastric glands. So these gastric glands are going to produce an enzyme that is known as a pepsin. So this pepsin is released into the small intestine. Okay, secreted into small intestine. Okay, the small intestine, now it is going to have the pepsin. So what is the importance of the pepsin? In the small intestine, you will see the food material. Okay, in the small intestine, the food material is present. The food material contains what? Proteins. Okay, next, vitamins. Okay, next is the minerals, everything. Okay, these all components are present in the protein. All components are present in the food material. So now this food material is reached into the small intestine. In the small intestine, this food material is present. here the proteins are there. The protein has to be broken down. The protein has to be broken down. So now what will happen? This pepsin will come to the protein and it will break down the proteins. Okay. So when the proteins are broken down by the pepsin, what you will get? You will get the peptones. Okay. Let us consider this is the structure of the protein. Okay. This is the structure of the protein. So the pepsin, okay, the pepsin is going to act on it. As a result, the protein is broken down into small fragment. These small fragments are nothing but the peptones. So how the peptones are obtained? The peptones are obtained by the breakdown of the proteins, by an enzyme known as a pepsin. Okay. So hence the pepsin is going to help in the digestion of the proteins. Okay. Next, remember one most important thing, that is a bile. Okay. Bile, it is not an enzyme. Okay. Bile is not an enzyme. Remember it. In the exams, they will ask about the bile. Okay. So in the multiple choice also, they will ask so about the bile juice. Okay. So remember, bile is not an enzyme. Okay. But even though it is not an enzyme, it is going to help in the digestion of the fat. Okay. Bile juice help in the digestion of fat. Which organ is going to secrete the bile juice? The liver. Okay. The liver is the organ. It is going to secrete the bile juice. So when the liver is producing the bile juice, okay, where it is going to release the duodenum? Okay, what is the duodenum? Okay, duodenum. Okay, let us see. This is the stomach. This is the esophagus. Okay, after the esophagus, you will see the stomach. Okay, the stomach, and the stomach enters into leads to the another organ, another structure. Okay, this is the small intestine. So this is the small intestine. So can you see the region between the stomach and the small intestine? So the region between the stomach and small intestine, this region is known as duodenum. Okay, so this is known as duodenum. So this duodenum is a small structure of the alimentary canal present between the stomach and small intestine. So here the liver is going to release its secretion. Okay, this is the liver. Liver is going to release its secretions into the duodenum. So when the food is passing, from the stomach to the small intestine. So now here the food is mixing with the secretions of the liver. What is the secretion? The secretion is known as bile. Okay, bile is not an enzyme. So now what will happen? The acidic food. Okay, the acidic food is going to turn into basic nature of the food. Okay, so what will happen? Why it is turning acidic to basic? Because there is a bile. The bile is secreted by the liver when the food is passing through the duodenum. Okay, so next, what the bile juice will do? Bile juice is going to act on the fats. So fat, it is a complex food material. Okay, so when the fats are broken down by bile juice, the fats are going to turn into fatty acids. Okay, that such kind of process known as emulsification. Okay, the fat is going to turn into tiny droplets. Okay, such kind of tiny droplets of the fat formation is known as emulsification. Okay, emulsification. Emulsification process is done by the bile juice. Okay. So next is the amylase. So amylase is of two types. Okay, one is the salivary amylase, another amylase is normal amylase, which is released into the intestine, alimentary canal. So here the pancreas is the organ. The pancreas are going to produce the amylase enzyme. So this pancreas also going to release their secretions into the duodenum. What is the duodenum? Here the C-shaped structures, that is known as duodenum. So here the pancreas are going to release their secretions into the duodenum. Okay, so that enzyme, that secretion is nothing but amylase. It is an enzyme. So here the pancreatic juice is going to act on the carbohydrates, and when the carbohydrates are broken down, it leads to the releasing of the sugars like maltose, glucose, and so on. These are the sugars. So carbohydrates are nothing but complex sugars. Carbohydrates means complex sugars. So like complex sugars like starch is a complex sugar. Next, glycogen, it is also a complex sugar, and so on. Okay, next, that trypsin. So the trypsin is released by an organ that is also known as a pancreas. Pancreas are going to produce three types of hormones, that is amylase, trypsin, and lipase. Okay, so the trypsin, what is going to do? It is going to act on the proteins only. Okay, in the pepsin and trypsin, both pepsin and trypsin both are going to act on the proteins. Okay, both are going to act on the proteins. As a result, so if the trypsin is going to act on the protein, what will happen? The proteins will get broken down into peptones. Okay, so proteins are nothing but a complex. Okay, the proteins are the complex one, and peptones are the small broken parts of the proteins. Okay, next is the lipase. Okay, so pancreas are going to produce the lipase enzyme also. When the lipase is acting on the fats are going to turn into fatty acids and also glycerol. So what is meant by fatty acid and glycerol? These are nothing but broken parts of the fats. Okay, broken material of the fats, they are known as, so that is known as digestion of the enzyme, or the digestion of the lipases, digestion through the lipase, that is nothing but fat. So next is the intestinal glands. In the intestine, okay, in the intestine there are some glands. Okay, those glands of the intestine is going to produce a peptidase. Peptidase means, so just now we have seen, just wait a minute. Okay, so next is the peptide. There is a peptones. Okay, small broken parts of the protein. These peptones are even further broken down, that is nothing but peptidase. Okay, so peptidase, it is an enzyme. Okay, when the peptidase act on the peptones, these peptones are going to turn into small individual molecules or small individual nutrients. They are known as amino acids. Okay, so here you can see the proteins are broken down into peptones by an enzyme known as a pepsin. Okay, by an enzyme is known as a pepsin, and here the same peptones are broken down by an enzyme known as peptidase. So hence you will see the formation of nutrients like amino acids. Okay, so next is the sucrase. Sucrase is the sugar. So when the intestinal glands release secretions, okay, so that is nothing but sucrase. This is sucrase, an enzyme. It is going to act on the sugar. Okay, what is that sugar? Sucrose. When the sucrose is acted, when the sucrase acts on the sucrose, it is going to turn into glucose. Okay, it means the sucrose is going to turn into glucose when the sucrase is acted. Okay, so this is about different enzymes and substrates. So different enzymes are substrate secreted by the organ, okay, or gland. So secreted into which organ? Okay, that is here, that is a structure over here. And digestive juice next acts on and products. So these are the different enzymes that helps in the digestion. So here remember one most important thing. Generally if you see anything, okay, like an enzyme, okay, enzyme will have the suffix. What is suffix? After a word. Okay, here we can see peptidase. Okay, peptidase. So in the word peptidase, peptidase. So here the word ase is the suffix. Okay, next sucrase. Okay, example sucrase. Here the word ase is the suffix. Okay, so in these enzymes, if you find ase, okay, ase suffix, okay, it is an enzyme. Okay, here you can see sucrase, ase is there, so it is an enzyme. Peptidase, ase is there, it is an enzyme. Lipase, ase is there, that is, it is an enzyme. But a few enzymes will not follow this rule. Okay, like what is an enzyme? Like trypsin. Okay, like trypsin. Do you find ase? No. you don't find AAC in the trypsin enzyme. Okay, hence, even though it doesn't have AAC suffix, it is an enzyme. Okay, but what is the use of using this trick? By using this AAC trick, by seeing on the spot, you can identify whether it is a protein or not. So in the protein, if you find AAC, definitely it is a protein. Okay, definitely it is a protein. Such kind of trick is going to help you in finding out the enzymes. Okay, in the match the following or in the one mark answer. Okay, so the small trick is AAC is nothing but it is a suffix. Generally, it is present in the enzymes. Okay. So next, bile juice. Remember, bile juice is not an enzyme. Bile juice, what is a bile juice? Bile juice is nothing but it is a combination of bile salts. It contains bile salts. It is not an enzyme. Okay. Next, okay, fine. So these enzymes are going to act on different substances, and those substances are broken down into different products. Okay. So what are those products? This is food material. The food material which containing the proteins, vitamins, fats, okay, next sugars, etc., complex sugars, etc. This is nothing but food material. So now digestion is occurred. What will happen if the digestion is occurred? What will happen? These food materials are going to turn into nutrients. Okay, nutrients. So what is the difference between the food material and nutrients? The food is complex. Okay, the protein is like this. Okay, the protein is complex. Okay, the fat, the sugars are in this way. Okay, the sugars are in this way, like complex sugars like starch and glycogen and so on. So these are complex. Your body cannot take such kind of complex food materials, and your body needs simple nutrients like here you can see amino acids and glucose. Okay, next is fatty acids. These are the simple nutrients. Hence, to make the body to take all these the important components, your body has to digest the food material. It means your body has to digest the complex food material into simple nutrients. Such kind of process is known as digestion. Okay, such kind of a breakdown of the complex food materials into simple nutrients. This is known as a digestion process. When the digestion is completed, you will see the nutrients will be formed. These nutrients are most important for your body. Okay, these nutrients are most important for your body. Why are these nutrients are important for your body? Why? Because your body needs these nutrients to build their cells. Okay, to produce the cells, what is required? To produce the cells, the nutrients are required. What are the nutrients? Nutrients like amino acids, nutrients like sugars, like glucose, maltose, fructose, and so on, and nutrients like fatty acids, and nutrients like minerals, and so on. They all are important for the production of the new cells and growth and development of the body. It means if the body has to be grown and developed, these nutrients are most important. Okay, so this is about digestion. So these nutrients, simple nutrients, are absorbed. Okay, absorbed into blood through intestine. Okay, so how these nutrients are absorbed? When you see, okay, so generally, if you see the small intestine, okay, the small intestine, it is an organ in the alimentary canal. Okay, let us see, this is small intestine. So in the small intestine, you will see small tiny finger like projections inside the alimentary canal. Inside the small intestine, you will see finger like projections. If you take out small section and if you maximize it, how it looks? Okay, it looks in this way. Okay, this is a finger like projection. Okay, so this is the villi. Okay, so this is a cross section of the small intestine. This is the villi. So in the villi, these are finger like projections. Just now you have seen the food material. Okay, the food is broken down into small nutrients. Okay, with it, small nutrients like amino acids, next to sugars, fatty acids, and so on. These nutrients are absorbed by these villi. okay, these nutrients are absorbed by the villi. It means the villi is going to take these nutrients into them. So again, see here, these fingerlet projections are known as villi. These villi will have the blood supply. Okay, these villi have the blood supply. Okay, so these nutrients are taken up by the villi, and the villi is going to mix the nutrients into blood vessels. Okay, so now it means the blood vessels are going to take the nutrients from the small intestine through the villi. Hence, now the blood vessel will have all nutrients. Okay, now the blood vessel have the all nutrients. Now this blood vessel have all the nutrients, and this nutrient containing blood will be supplied to the body for the growth of the body and repair of the body. Okay, so this is the importance of the digestion. So what is the importance of this villi? This villi is important to increase surface area. So here the surface area is going to increase by this villi. What is meant by surface area? Here we can see this is a small cube. Okay, so this is 2 centimeters, 2 centimeters, 2 centimeters, and 2 centimeters. If you cut the cube into two parts, okay, into two parts, so what is the surface? So it is 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, okay, 2, 2, and also, wait a minute, so in this way, and here also the 2 centimeters, and also here will be the 1 centimeter, also 1 centimeter. Okay, so how much centimeters has been increased? Okay, so there is some increase, and also here will be the 2 centimeters, 2 centimeters. So 1 plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, 12 centimeters. Okay, how many are there? 8. Okay, 2 4 is 8. Okay, 8 centimeters. Previously here is the 8 centimeters, now it is the 12 centimeters. Okay, 2 centimeters, 2 centimeters, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So total 12 centimeters. So can you see the surface area is increased from the 8 centimeters to 12 centimeters? Why? Because you have cut the cube into two. So again, if you cut the cube into two, what will happen again? It will increase. It will go on increasing the surface area. It means to cover the paint, to paint these cubes, how much paint is required? You require more amount of paint when you compare to the first cube. In the same way, the intestine. If the intestine is simple. If the intestine is simple in this way, okay, without any villi, okay, and another small intestine with villi, so here is the villi, okay. So now see, if you compare both these intestine tubes, okay, this one has a less surface area, and this has the more surface area. Okay, this is only the difference. Here is the less surface area, here is the more surface area. Okay, so why the surface area is important? Just now we have seen the cube, the divided cube, to make the paints of the divided cube you need more amount of paint. Here also, to make the surface area to increase, okay, the villi is present. It means the villi is going to increase the surface area, and if the surface area is increased, the absorption of the nutrients is also more. Okay, this is importance of the surface area. So excess amount of water, here you can see the products are absorbed first into the villi, then blood vessels, and then into the lymph vessels. Okay, lymph is nothing but a fluid. Okay, in the blood there is a fluid, that fluid is known as lymph. Okay, so after the maximum absorption, the food moves into the small intestine. Okay, so the here you can see the stomach. Okay, here is the stomach. So the stomach, in the stomach, the absorption, some amount of digestion will occur. After the digestion of the food in the stomach up to some extent, so it will move into the small intestine. All the complete breakdown of the food materials and absorption of the food materials will take place in the small intestine. Okay, so excess amount of the food material. And if you eat the food material, some amount of food material cannot be digested. Example, fiber, dietary fiber. It will not get digested inside the small intestine. So that food material cannot be digested, and it will move into the large intestine. So large intestine, in the large intestine, what will happen? In the large intestine, excess amount of water will be absorbed. Okay. So next, after the absorption, defecation. Defecation process will be seen. What is defecation? Defecation is nothing but excretion. Okay, through the large intestine, excretion will take place. That is elimination of waste and digested undigested food material through anus. Okay, in the last class also we have seen digestion will starts with mouth. Okay, digestion will starts with mouth. Okay, and ends with the anus. Okay, so mouth and anus. Between the mouth and anus, the alimentary canal is there. Okay, so the undigested food material will exit out through the anus. So the food that passes through the anus containing considerable amounts of fats, proteins, carbohydrates, etc. Why? Because the absorption of nutrients is not exactly 100% in the small intestine. Even though the waste material is excreted through the anus, those excreted waste material containing considerable amount of nutrients like fats, proteins, carbohydrates and so on. Okay, so remember, 100% digestion will not occur, 100% absorption of nutrients will not occur. Okay, if you eat 1 kg of rice, okay, in the 1 kg of rice, okay, only 20% is utilized for your growth, your body growth and development. Means remaining 80% or 800 grams, okay, 800 grams is wasted. Okay, is wasted. It means you cannot utilize complete energy, okay, from the food material. So here the flowchart of human digestive system. Flowchart of the human digestive system. First it will starts with the food. When the food is kept in the mouth, so it moves to the buccal cavity and in the pharynx, esophagus, cardiac stomach and so on. Here you see the cardiac stomach. What is cardiac stomach? Cardiac stomach is nothing but the stomach region near to the heart, that is known as cardiac stomach. Next, the pyloric stomach. Pyloric stomach, here it is nothing but where the pyloric sphincters are present. Okay, so next is the duodenum. What is the duodenum? Just now we have seen they are C-shaped. Okay, this are this is nothing but esophagus. Okay, this is the stomach, and after stomach there is a duodenum. Okay, there is a duodenum. So next, duodenum leads to the small intestine. Here we can see the small intestine, and also after the small intestine you will see the large intestine. Okay, large intestine, that is surrounding the small intestine, this is the large intestine, and large intestine leads to the rectum. Okay, this is the rectum and this is the anus. So this is the rectum and this is the anus. Okay, so it means the from mouth to anus, this elementary channel, the elementary canal is present. Okay, so next, in the duodenum you will see the secretions of the liver and the pancreas. In the flowchart you can see liver and pancreas. Okay, here there are some questions like enzymes. Name the enzymes which act upon carbohydrates like ptyalin, okay, amylase, sucrase. They are the all enzymes that is going to act on the carbohydrates. Next, which juice contains no enzymes? Which digestive juice does not contain enzyme? Okay, that is the bile juice. Remember this, bile juice is not an enzyme, but it helps in the digestion process. What are the end products of the fats? Fatty acids and glycerol, that is the two products. Okay, the fatty acids and glycerol, these are the two products, okay, that is formed after the digestion of the fat materials. Okay, next, what are the enzymes that act upon the proteins like pepsin and trypsin? Okay, these are the two enzymes that act on the proteins. Okay, and that's it in this lecture. And if you have any doubts or questions, ask us in the comment section and we will try to clear it. Okay, and we'll clear your doubts when you ask in the comment section. Okay, and we'll discuss the next topic in the next lecture.